He's now going to be able to save your child's life. So. He can't come back here. He doesn't have the documentation. So,
and it's my turn, right?
It's my turn
now, right?
The White House is saying this is going
to be looked at. It's my turn now. And then you help me, right?
So it's so broad, and you can imagine that DHS officers and CPB are going to handle it from different parts of the country, different
things. When it comes to immigration law, which bars people from coming to the United States because of their religious orientation, at the same time, tend to have much more discretion when it comes to immigration law, rather than say the Constitution. It does. This government has a ground to stand on.
Historically, the government has the authority to issue executive orders. We've been fighting pirates in the high seas from when our nation started. But we never stopped taking refugees. Today, the president called for refugees.
But I'm asking you not your opinion, but your
vote. Not out to right there.
The president has the authority to do what he did. I believe it's unconstitutional.
Maybe, Mom, put something in Sanders out.
And I also believe that Congress has the plenary power to deal with immigration laws. They, Monday morning, should be stepping out, if not this weekend, stepping into the space of the president because they can enact legislation. They can
Then why don't they do something?
His discretion in how to execute them to protect us.
Mommy, this one hit me when I fell down. So just be careful, then.
Mommy, this one up and this one down.
Yeah, be careful, okay?
Do not let it down, okay, Mommy?
Okay.
I am concerned about my brothers and sisters. My sister
and Mommy can fight.
The greatest entrepreneurial spirit hails from immigration. The first lady did in the past. We have to get this right. Mind you, the genuineness of the president and the first lady when it comes to immigration and